Hey, YouTubers. This is AR15 Guy. I'm starting a new series, and I'm going to do my best with it. I'm kind of giving, after last night's little rant that you guys watched, maybe some of you watched, some of you didn't, I would hope that some, if after watching this, that you would go back and watch that one. But I've decided today that I'm going to do a video a week on the Constitution, and I'm going to just work in numerical order and just go from there. My reason for doing this is because I really feel like we as a nation have gone away from the Constitution. Like, even as I'm studying today, I studied up on the First Amendment, and you know, I know the Second Amendment pretty well, but beyond that, you know, the Constitution is there as a mold for our government to follow. And some of the stuff that I read about the Fifth Amendment and the Fourth Amendment and all that, I'll go over later on down the line, really got my eyes opening to just how genius our framers were, and the fact that we have gotten as a nation so far away from the Constitution, and we're paying the consequences for it. The Constitution, if we had followed it the way it was intended, we would not be in the situation we are now. You know, some people can say, well, it was, you know, freedom, you know, slavery and all that stuff wasn't necessarily in the Constitution, and we've made changes to it and whatnot. That's correct. But the overall general way that the government is in our lives, if we had followed, when writing laws, the Constitution, we wouldn't be here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one amendment a week, go over it, I'm going to read it verbatim, and then I'm going to give my thoughts on it, kind of as a layman. I'm no constitutional scholar. If you get in trouble in court, don't use my video to help you out. I'm just giving kind of what I feel, what I gather from it, and kind of what I think. So, with that said, let's start with the First Amendment. So the First Amendment to the Constitution reads, and I'll read it verbatim, "Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press or the right of the people to peaceably assemble and to petition the government for a redress of grievances." Now, when I read that, the first thing that comes to mind for me is all of the stuff that's going on with the different atheist groups saying we cannot have crosses on public land. And I don't think that's right. I don't think that that's what the First Amendment was saying. I think the First Amendment was trying to keep us from having an established religion in this country. You know, like the Muslim nations, their religion is established, it is government law. Does our Constitution and does some of our laws go along with certain religious principles? Yeah, because the basic principle of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, or the way it was originally written, was the pursuit of property, follows under that. I don't have a right to kill someone. It is against the law to kill someone. Thou shalt not murder. So, in a sense, yes, they follow that, but I think that it's kind of a logical following. And so I think that this whole idea that we as a nation have to remove any resemblance of religion or Christianity or Judaism from our society or from our government is just simply not the case. The case here is that we cannot say you have to worship Allah, or you have to worship Jesus, or you have to worship Buddha. We're saying that we are a free people. You can have your religious beliefs as long as they follow within the law. Nowhere in there does it say that we have to remove the Ten Commandments. Nowhere in there does it say that we have to remove crosses and that we can't cross headstones, at federal cemeteries. Nowhere in there does it say that, or even I can't even find that it even comes close to that. All it is saying is we shall not have established religion. Meaning the government cannot say you have to believe in this God or you're going to jail. So, and the other part to that is the freedom of press. And press is kind of, this could be considered press. And the freedom of speech, allowing us to speak freely against or for our government, against or for people. The thing of it is that I was thinking today after I made that video, just because you are offended doesn't mean that your rights have been taken away or that you have the liability to take somebody else's rights. It's kind of like if you're being shot and it hurts, you're still alive. If you get offended, you're still free. When we get to a society where nobody can be offended, we are no longer free. So I would rather be offended than not to have my ability to speak my mind. So anyway, that's kind of what I want to go over today. Like I said, I'm going to try and do a Constitution Amendment one a week. Next week we'll do the Second Amendment. Most of the people who follow my channel know that one well. But this is going to be kind of a layman's Constitution interpretation. And maybe somebody will get maybe I can educate somebody. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Leave comments, leave suggestions, put your interpretation of this amendment, and anything that I may have missed. So, thanks for watching, guys. AR-15 guy out.